Hello, I'm Chris Menard. In today's short video, I'm going to cover three cool features about Microsoft OneDrive. So if you're using Excel, Word, PowerPoint, the ideal place probably to store your files is in OneDrive. So let me cover, before I start this, there are chapters down below about the three different features, but I want to quickly discuss the two different versions of OneDrive you may see. So the first version is actually broken up into two parts. You've got a Microsoft 365 Personal, which you can subscribe to if you want to, and there's the price over here. I'll put a link down below to this one. Very similar, so still number one, and this is what I actually have. I've got Microsoft 365 Family, so you pay a little more, but you can put it up to, you can share this with six people. The second OneDrive you have is you've got OneDrive for work or school. This formerly was called OneDrive for business, but now we call it OneDrive for work or school. The big difference between these two, the work and school versus the family slash personal, is the family personal, you control that one. The OneDrive for work or school is controlled by your company or your university. But let me talk about the three cool features that I love about OneDrive. So I have Microsoft Excel running. So feature number one is I can quickly rename a file that I've saved to OneDrive. So I've saved this to OneDrive, and I know that because AutoSave is turned on in the top right. I don't like the name of this file, Credit Card YouTube Video 3. I'm gonna just change it to By Chris Menard. So you can rename a file without closing the file, having to go and right-click and do a rename. I just renamed this file. The other cool feature that I love about OneDrive, and this again applies to Word, Excel, it doesn't matter, is if you make a mistake, OneDrive is doing versioning up here. So here's a great example. I'm going to delete the worksheet that I need right here for a future video. Bye-bye. I close this file out. I come back in later today or tomorrow and open it up. And by the way, there's the name change. And I'm looking down for that worksheet and realize, oh no, I hope I didn't delete it. So if that happens, you come up here. There's the name change. That is where it's stored. But here is your version history over here to the right. I'm going to come over here and click on Open Version here. Restore. And I'm back in business. I use the version history all the time, especially because I'm in training. If I screw up a file, it's no big deal. I just go and pull up the previous version that I knew was correct. So there's that feature. By the way, just to point this out, that also works in Microsoft Word. It works in PowerPoint. There's the name change. There's where this is stored. And there's version history. The third item I want to discuss is Microsoft OneDrive in Outlook. So in Outlook, I've got an email with attachments. I get these all the time. If I come and point to one of the attachments and click, there's upload, but there's also upload all attachments. So how cool is this? You get an email with 15 attachments. You can upload all attachments to OneDrive right here. And by the way, there's my Microsoft 365 family, and there is my Microsoft OneDrive for work or school versus OneDrive personal is what they actually call that. Anyway, I hope this helps. I hope you enjoyed the three cool tips. Let me know if you have any questions about OneDrive. Have a great day. Feel free to subscribe. Thank you.